Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Carl Thormeyer.
All right, sky cam 8 Soledad shows a couple things. Shows the low clouds down the Salinas Valley, but see the mountains off to the east, so they're relatively shallow. Marine layer, about 1,500 feet this morning, and you see the higher clouds above. And let's take a look at the satellite radar for the last 12 hours and see how that translates. And you can see here that the higher clouds have moved up with a few showers in the mountains overnight, but we don't expect anything like that around here. It could have a thunder sprinkle maybe in the extreme southeastern mountains of the Tri-County area, but really nothing to be too concerned about. You see a lot of low clouds along the coast, pretty typical for this time of year, and they've moved inland, of course, overnight. Temperatures right now mostly in the mid-50s around the area, and if we try to nail down that marine layer, we see up at 1,200 feet, 1,250 feet in Scotts Valley, it's 52, which is cooler than near the surface. So we know the marine layer is higher than that, but up at 2,600 feet, it's 68. So again, the marine layer depth about 1,500 feet right now, and pretty steady, actually. Now, the reason for the marine layer is, of course, a large ridge of high pressure aloft at 18,000 feet, and warmer air up here as well. And that's going to continue all weekend. But as time goes on, as we move into Monday, and in a Tuesday and Wednesday, we're developing another trough of low pressure along the coast at 18,000 feet. And that means cooler air moving back in once again. So we're going to have to wait a while for that first heat wave of the September-October time period. Now, if we look at the wind and low cloud model from Microcast, you can see that the low clouds do pull back to near the coast today. And then they move inland tonight, but not quite as far. And then tomorrow, they pull back considerably. And I think the marine layer is going to be more shallow tomorrow. Temperatures are going to be warmer inland, and we're probably going to see more sun along the coast. But for today, temperatures will range from the 67 in San Francisco to the upper 70s down in the South Bay, and then in the Santa Clara Valley from 82 in San Jose into the low 90s around Morgan Hill and dropping back into the 80s by the time you get down to Hollister. And then down the Salinas Valley, we'll start going back up again, so we're at 88 by the time you get to King City. And down around the lakes, it's going to be pretty close to 100 today. And over in the Monterey Peninsula, mostly in the low to mid-60s. And again, up in the Santa Cruz County area, we're looking at mid-70s along the coast to mid-80s in the mountains. And again, all these temperatures, pretty normal, really, for this time of year. On the bay, pretty quiet, 2 to 4 feet of surf out there today in the exposed beaches. And they can look at the forecast then. We'll just say the low clouds will drift back into the valleys again tonight. And we'll have that late coastal fog and probably some dense fog tomorrow morning near the coast, and I couldn't get all those words in the box. I did the best I could. Probably clearing to the coast tomorrow. And then looking at the longer range forecast, we're looking at temperatures warming up again this weekend, cooling off toward the middle of the week. So that's what we're up.
Right.
Up for.
Very different, a very different picture from what's going on along the eastern
Absolutely.
Seaboard. I know the hurricane hit the Outer Banks of North Carolina
near
this
Morehead
morning.
Morehead City, yeah.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Morehead City. And then later tonight, I just want to talk about New York City. I know a lot of cities, all the cities along the seaboard's affected, mm-hmm. but it's just so odd to hear New York City evacuations this morning and yesterday. The mayor saying that they were going to shut down the subway system for the first time ever. And this is going to affect around 300,000 people, especially in one part in the southern tip of Manhattan. So they're
right.
expecting the Category 1 storm, albeit it's a Category 1 storm, is still going to be pretty powerful. And the mayor is telling everyone that, you know what, you can expect flooding in New York City.
Well, you've got to keep in mind there's going to be a lot of rain with this. There's
right.
about 5 to 7 inches of rain overnight in North Carolina, and that's all heading up toward New York. And they had a tropical storm last year, and it flooded part of the underground areas. And so, yeah, this is a significant issue.
It's a significant issue. And, of course, thank you, Carl, for your very, very accurate weather reports. And we'll have more coming up.